And I made it over here. Hope you did too. And welcome, everybody, to another edition of the NightLife Show. Now, as I mentioned, we're here and we are doing this program from outside of the train station here in Orlando. And what we're going to do is talk about trains tonight, both large and small. So any of you people out there who are interested in trains, you might enjoy this particular program. Now, out here today, shooting this fine program here in Winter Garden, is our associate here on the NightLife Show, Mr. Rick Zimmer, who is here once again. How are you today?
Hey, I'm here. It's a lovely day, boy.
It is, isn't it?
Hearing your comments there to the Clevelandites, you know, they need to be here. This is the place to be in January.
It is a beautiful day in the neighborhood, isn't it?
It's lovely. Can you say that? Sure you can.
So we're having a good time out here. Tonight's subject, oh, by the way, Rick Zimmer, who does help us out here with the show, of course, is a professional photographer here in Orlando, so it is good to, so that's why everything is all lined up just right. So anyway, today's program is about trains. That's true. Well, talking about high tech, we're going to go back even further with model trains.
Okay.
This is back, another film clip I located back, to me it looks like the late 30s or early 40s, okay?
Low tech, early tech here.
Early tech. And what's happening here, this is a brand of train which you could, any young boy could snap together and put together himself. It was kind of almost like a kit that you could buy, and any young man could do this. And you could, just to show how easy and portable these trains were, this promotional film was with some Boy Scouts who take the train out camping with them. Now, where they got the extension cord, I have no idea.
Lots of sticks together, I think, to get their power.
I don't know, but you're going to see electric trains built by this Boy Scout troop way out in the middle of the woods. A weird film. Now, it was shot silent, okay, so we had to add in a little music here to get the thing going, but it's kind of an interesting film clip about these Boy Scouts. So let's go back to the Boy Scouts building their train
in the woods.
Very strange. Here we go. We're moved over here just slightly, and I was just noticing they have big planters outside this place with the letters ACL. What's that mean, I wonder?
Well, American Civil Liberty. Atlantic Coastline Railroad. That's it. The Atlantic Coastline Railroad is what this was for. An old Florida railroad line that I don't even know if they're in business anymore. I think they're defunct now.
Huh. Interesting.
Very funky.
Yes, a funky railroad. Funky. A defunky railroad. Anyway, but we thought that we would come out here and say our goodbye here is before the time ran out.
I mentioned something, Kerry, before we signed off. And I've noticed, what is this here?
Oh, yes.
A little something here.
Well, that's true. This is, I guess, now I think about probably the first show which I have a beard on it. And for various reasons.
Watch
one of them
razor?
Of a, that, well, perhaps, but I have not grown a beard in over 20 years. And I said it was time just so people could see what I look like with a beard. Keep it for a while. I might shave it off. I don't know.
Is a 5-year-old as you?
Yeah, that's right. That's a 5-year-old.
But, yeah, I thought maybe we'd match now. You know, the crew should match. You know,
we all have beards here
on
the show.
On camera, you don't see me that much, but he has a beard now, so we now have our matching look. I think it's good.
You've had a beard on and off for how long?
Oh, 5 or 6 years now, I guess. Yeah, it's been
interesting.
A
while. So. I can see that we're rapidly running not only out of sunlight, but out of time, so we must be going. I want to thank you once again, Rick, for helping us out.
It's fun being here. Appreciate you having me again.
All right. And, of course, we'll be back again next week on the NightLife Show, and I hope that you will join us then. We have some more exciting things with the world of home video. So this is Kerry Decker and
Rick Zimmer.
Thanking you for your time this time. Until next time, we'll see you again next week. Bye-bye now.